In this short video, I'm going to tell you a few things about ThingSpeak. We're going to use ThingSpeak as our cloud server, and there's just a few things that I want to show you that we don't have time for in the other videos. So I'll put the link for ThingSpeak in the description. It's free for you to use. You can register 4 channels there, and each channel's got 8 fields. So it's really a lot of data that you can use on or log to ThingSpeak. You can also, there's many apps available for ThingSpeak where you can display your channels on your cell phone as well. So after you've registered on ThingSpeak, let me show you a few things. Let me go to my account. Now you will see that you've got a total of 3 million logs per year on your free account. It will also show you how many of those logs you've used, and it will also tell you here how many logs you can use per day. Now you can believe me, it's quite enough for basic projects like we are doing. So let me go to my channels. Now I've got different channels set up here, and let's go to this specific channel. In our next video, where we're going to log 2 temperature values as well as a pH value, you can see it's already logging here on this system, and there's just a few things that I want to show you concerning the channels. Now you can first go to channel settings. Now channel settings, there's a channel ID. You're going to use that channel ID when you register your channel in your app on your cell phone. The channel name is just the name that you assign to that specific channel. Description is just the description of the channel. You can put anything in there. Then in this channel, you've got 8 fields. Now fields are basically a set of data that's coming in from your Wi-Fi or your GSM module. So in this case, we've got temperature 1, temperature 2, and pH. So I can disable them and I can put them back again there. pH, you can name them depending on how much data you send to that specific field or that specific channel, you will define your different fields. Then if we move down, here's some general data, metadata that you can put in. You can also tag this, put certain tags so that it could be found in searches. If you've got a website, you can put your website in here. And if you've got software on the depository that somebody can use, you can put it here. You can put your elevation, and you can here say that the channel location must be shown to the public. You can also link a YouTube video for you there, and then you can just save your channel. Now let me show you here under sharing. Under sharing, you can either keep your channel private, you can share it with everybody, or you can share it with certain individuals. So if you want to make it public, you can just select that middle one. Then a next tab here is the API keys. We're going to use this write key in our software. So you'll copy this write key and you'll put it in your software. And the Wi-Fi model will use this, in order to connect to that specific channel. The read key you can also use when you want to read data from your ThingSpeak account. But this one, the write key, is the most important one here. Let's go to data import and export. Now all the data that's you write to ThingSpeak will be locked in a CSV file, and it's comma delimited, so you can easily import this into Excel or Google Sheets, and you can also use your data there. So you can just download that file and use it. You can also upload data to the specific channel. Say you've got already data that you want to add to this channel, you can also do that. Then you've got your public view. Now the public view, if your channel is public, set to public in sharing, then this will be what the public will see concerning that channel. And here's your private view, and this is what you will see. Now let me show you quickly. Each one of these fields can be individually set up. Like this specific field, I can name it, it's temperature 1, and I can say it's a line that must be drawn. You've got other options, bars, column, spline, step, in the type of chart that will be displayed. Then you can also say it must display, say 2 days or 1 day of data, or you can say how many samples must be displayed. In this case, I've selected 20 samples. You can also select the range on your y-axis. In this case, it's 10 to 40 that I've set. A few other settings, but those are the most important. So, like I've said, this is our next project, 2 temperature values and a pH value. But there's something else that I want to show you here. In your channel, you can add widgets. Now these widgets are, for instance, a gauge, a numeric value, a lamp indicator, but let's have a look at the gauge. Now let's say we want our pH field is field number 3, so we want to, let's say the minimum is 0 and the maximum is a pH of 14, and there's no units for the pH. Our intervals, update interval 15 seconds, I think, is the minimum there. Our range, now these are indicators on the dial. Now let's say our first range is from 1, or let's say make that from 0 to a pH of, let's make that 4, and we color that red. Let's add another one and let's make that a green color, and let's take that from 4.5 to a pH of, let's say, 8, and let's add another one and let's say that's a pH from 8.5 to a pH of 14 that will be a other color as well. We can make that red. Let's go back, so you can just select your color there. Let's take red. Right, and that's it then. So now you've got a gauge, and this is the readings as they come in. There you can see one just came in, and you've got a gauge for this pH channel field of yours. You can also do the same for your field number 1, that temperature. There you can see I've touched that temperature just previously, like we've said, and you can see the temperature has risen and it's moving down again. So you can add gauges, all type of things here. Really a very nice free cloud service that's provided by ThingSpeak. Easy to use. Our Wi-Fi module will connect with this very easily, and very handy tool to use for aquaponics and hydroponics growers. So if you enjoyed this video, if you found any value in this, please like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. Thank you and bye bye.